boy went to visit his father out of town, where he had moved to an upscale neighborhood. It rains a lot in Florida, and it was raining on that night, but everyone says exercise is good. He went out for a walk to the convenience store to go out and bring some candy back. But some people leave and they never come home. That night was a one-way track. For the neighborhood watchman was driving in his car on a rainy night, looking for a young man who might have a part to play in his personal race war. And what if this trolling vigilante, sowing terror on a racist whim, what if when he found this teenage boy, he instead had found a man more like him? What if things were different? Where would he be bound? What if Trayvon had stood his ground? When Zimmerman approached in an unmarked vehicle, when the high school student ran, what if instead he had stood there in the rain with his Skittles and his Arizona can? What if trying to avoid a conflict with this cracker who was evidently messed up in the head, Trayvon had said, "I feel like my life's in danger," and he had shot this vigilante dead? What if things were different? Where would he be bound? What if Trayvon had stood his ground? Would this hooded youth be gingerly arrested, treated for his wounds and then let free? Would he be hailed as a hero by the NRA, by Limbaugh, Beck, and Hannity? Would he be found not guilty by any jury in this country? Would he be allowed to keep his gun? Or would he be sitting in a prison cell watching pundits on the TV saying that kid really should have run? What if things were different? Where would he be bound? What if Trayvon had stood his ground?